LLM Studio has quickly become one of my favorite AI tools. If you're not already familiar with LLM Studio, you can kind of think of it like a chat front end and API for any of the open source models that are available on Hugging Face. I've been enjoying it because I can run everything locally on this really incredible Mac hardware that I have that largely goes unutilized unless I'm exporting a video. And I get to learn a little bit more about what makes all of these models different and what makes the paid models so special. My goal today is just to show off a handful of ways that I've used it up to this point, but more importantly, explore some of the features that I've wanted to dive into, but haven't taken the time to. Let's get into it. Okay, first, you can find everything that you need on lmstudio.ai. That's the URL. They have all the downloads for all the systems and instructions, etc. Once installed, it'll look something like this. There are three main modes. It boots into power user by default, which you'll use to load models, set up the API backend, etc. But you can use user, which is more of that conventional chat look and feel. Developer gives you a handful of extra menu options, I believe, when it's running a model. So you can inspect all the JSON output from your chat with the model, but that's very minor differences between these two modes. First thing that you need to do, and it'll probably guide you through this if you're running through the first time, is load models. Now, we're all familiar with DeepSeek. That's been all the rage this last month. You can get various versions of it here, depending on your needs, how much RAM your system has, etc. Other popular models are going to be Llama. Qwen is also a popular model that you can use. And one I really like is Mistral, specifically Codestral. Codestral is a coding model, and because it's focused on code, it gives pretty terse answers right out of the gate, so you don't have to train it down. Now, I've already downloaded this model, so all that's left is to load it. So we can click this play button to say use in new chat, or we can create a new chat using our chat interface. In this chat, load a model. I'll use Codestral. We can set all of the parameters based on our needs, system resources, and what else we plan to be running. I'm just going to load it with the defaults right now, since this is pretty much all I have open besides OBS. And we'll ask it something simple. Solve the FizzBuzz coding challenge in TypeScript. We get a pretty quick response. It'll tell us how many tokens per second. This isn't a huge model, but you know, it works great considering that we're on like a M3 Mac. So we're getting about 16 tokens per second. Not massive, but you know, fine. And our response looks pretty good. And all things considered, not super wordy. It does a decent job of describing what it did and why. Of course, if we want to get other answers, we can duplicate this and change the model. Let's see what we get from DeepSeek. It'll take a second to load, but we can take this duplicated or copied chat and now use our current model to get a new answer. Now, one thing that's fun about these reasoning models is that you can actually see the thought process here, which is very cool. Now, while we wait for this answer to render, something that I've really enjoyed about seeing the reasoning section or the thinking section of chats is that I can tell when it's holding on to a request that I made earlier on in the chat or losing context along the way of something that I still think is very important. So I love being able to see those to make sure that we stay exactly on the rails and with the right parameters that I want. All right, it's done significantly slower. This was 7.6 tokens a second, so quite a while, and it generated significantly more at 1,356. Now, the answer that it gives us is significantly more wordy, and the code solution itself is pretty different, notably different. I think it's possible that these would have been similar if we had specified if we just wanted it to log output or if we want that data to log out on our own terms. But overall, very cool. We can run both regular non-reasoning models and reasoning models all the same. Okay, so it works pretty good as a chat client. Something that I end up using AI a lot for is summary based on a document. For my use cases, it's usually a video that I've transcribed in my editing software, and I want to create a description because most people don't really read those, but it's nice to have them in there. I don't really give a shit about writing one. So let's play with a couple features. One, uploading a file for retrieval-augmented generation, see how that works. Also, kind of controlling the output using some kind of template or formula. To do this, let's start a new chat. Please create a video summary for YouTube using the attached SRT transcript file. Then we can simply drag and drop an SRT file. This is from my most recent video on Ghosty, the terminal emulator, which I absolutely love. You check that video out. The assistant is going to kind of make sure that this is a processable file. I think it is. It looks like it is. We'll show the citations that it's using down here. This is SRT format with timestamps. Let's open up the thinking and see what it's doing so far. So it seems to understand the task. We're making a YouTube video description from a transcript. They need to understand the transcript contents. Yeah, of course. It recognizes that there's timestamps in the text and starts to parse out what some of the possible sections may be. These are all words that I said or close to them. Yeah, it's breaking it down into bullet points, including a call to action. So let's see how it's doing. Now this is fine, but we didn't actually give it that much instruction. So it doesn't create any chapter markers, which would be nice. It just has these bullet points and it's not written in a very YouTube description-y kind of way. Now we could refine this with some additional prompting, but we also have this labs or advanced configuration button. And this gives us some pretty interesting options. First and foremost, we have a structured output field. So we can kind of define a JSON structure that we want to meet if we wanted to do like title, description, you know, tags, et cetera, and separate them that way. And since we've made this edit, we're now seeing that we're in a new unsaved preset. For this preset, let's change the system prompt. Okay, let's get a little bit more room. An effective description has the following characteristic. An example of proper chapter markers are as follows. Now I have an additional note that some SRT files start at 1 hour. And if this is the case, interpret that as 000. Let's save this as a preset and see if we can rerun this with that new preset in place. Okay, so now we have results and it looks pretty all right. This is kind of stupid, but I get where it got that from the whole like casual and fun comment. I honestly almost always end up deleting the first sentence or two from these when I copy the description. I would obviously tailor this up a little bit, but we can see that the prompt, the system prompt here works great. And now we have something that we can edit and reuse anytime I want to create an SRT. Now, just for fun, I'm gonna go to chan.dev dashboard and create a title and description. Now this whole page, it looks terrible, obviously. This was created for me by Cursor in a single prompt, and I'm fine with it looking terrible because it totally works. Let's add our Ghosty SRT file. I do have a system prompt in place, and let's just see how much better Claude does at this. All right, so forgive the atrocious styling, but I'll highlight it and we'll be able to read it. I have found that Claude specifically is really excellent at pulling out timestamps and details. Now my video was not 40 minutes long, so it's definitely off base, but it does a much better job of pulling out those topics with intention. I think the summary is much better. It definitely covers all of the topics that we covered. Again, in this video is just stupid. I would probably cut out this whole thing and just start with explore a new popular Ghosty terminal, etc. Okay, so we played a little bit with uploading files and adding a system prompt. We could do the structured output if we wanted to, but we got other things to move on to. Something that's interesting to me is how I can utilize these as an API, and we haven't talked about that at all. One, I just want to do it and see how I might be able to run some local versions of my website or local services using this. Also, I want to see if I can integrate it into my NeoVim setup. You know, over the last year, I've just been really interested in kind of bringing things back home, like bringing them, you know, on-prem again. And so I'm really curious if I could utilize Codestral through the Avante package inside of NeoVim. So let's try that out. So all this time we've been inside of this chat interface, but there are more places that we can explore. Obviously we can inspect the models that we have downloaded locally, inspect their source, etc., and we can discover new models. But what I'm interested in right now is this developer section. Now note that we don't have to be in developer mode to get this developer section. Here we can set up a process that we can access via curl and web interfaces. So let's load a code model because I'd like to eventually get this set up in NeoVim. We're getting this model load failure. And so this is a really interesting thing that we should talk about. Let's open up Activity Monitor. Now, if we look at the memory pane right now, you'll see that I am pretty pegged. Apple does a really good job of swapping memory, but Like this is pretty crazy right now. Now watch what happens when I go back into chat, keep this open over here, and eject our DeepSeek R1 distilled Qwen model. Look at that. That's crazy. So this is how much memory I'm using with, you know, NeoVim and OBS open. But just note, this is something that you will have to manage with limited system resources. So let's go back over to developer, try and load the model that we want again. Should be no problem now that we've ejected the previous model. And it looks like we're good to go. So let's try something. Let's copy this curl command. Looks like it's going to make requests to this localhost port. Seems like we have these endpoints that we can make requests from. Let's open up Ghosty and see if we can make a request. All right, so what do we have? We have a curl to this localhost port 1234 endpoint using chat completions, content type, an object, data, defining the model, and some parameters that I don't really know about. Let's hit enter. Okay, so in return, we get a chat ID, some technical details about the time in the model, and this array of choices, which includes some content from the assistant. Now, we didn't actually give it anything, so I think it's just spitting something random back. Let's try that again. Okay, so we have a role system and a role user. Okay, let's paste this again. So for content, we want to say return only the resulting code in TypeScript. And our prompt is write a promise that fetches a list of Pokemon. Let's try this again. Okay, so we have an answer. It didn't quite understand the prompt to just do the code, but it does look like somewhere in here is like an interface for Pokemon or returning a new Pokemon, fetching from Poke API. This all looks like it could very well be right. Okay, so if we're getting answers like this, how can I now incorporate that into NeoVim using the Avante package? Okay, so I know that I am going to have our time. So let's just ask Perplexity. How do I configure the NeoVim plugin Avante to use LM Studio endpoints instead of Claude? Let's go. Okay, to configure the Avante NeoVim plugin to use LM Studio endpoints instead of Claude, you need to modify the plugin's configuration to use OpenAI provider with a custom endpoint. Here's how you can do it. Start LM Studio. In your NeoVim configuration, update the Avante plugin. Replace the existing configuration with the following. All right, let's open our config. I think it's probably an init Lua. Let's check Avante. Possible that I put it in a directory. Yes, custom plugins Avante. Okay, it says to replace the whole thing with this, but these do not look comparable. What it looks like we need to do is use these options. So I'm going to change only these and put them in this add any options here section. Okay, so we set up the port. We're going to use an OpenAI model. Looks like we need to specify our model name. I think that is here. So we should be able to paste that in. Okay, and it says make sure to replace the local model, which we've done. Restart NeoVim to reload the configuration. Okay, so I'm just going to open up a new instance of NeoVim. Open up Avante on the side here. Ask, is TypeScript really better than JavaScript? Okay, so this did not work because our model is still Claude Sonnet 3.5. Okay, so we have our Avante Lua here. It does specify local true is important, which we have. Why are these options not getting loaded? Okay, so let's open up our Avante Lua again. Let's just, paste in the whole thing. Hey, this is my config. What's wrong with it? All right, your configuration is mostly correct, but you have a couple issues that need to be addressed. Provider, OpenAI. The main problem is you haven't specified the provider. Okay, provider, OpenAI. The ops table structure is not quite right. The OpenAI configuration should be nested under the ops table. Here's how it should look. Options, I see. Ah. Interesting. So that line is here, but it commented out. Oh, you know what? That was probably, I'm assuming that this was right, what it gave me, and it was a bad paste. It pasted right after this comment. Interesting. Okay, cool. So now we should be able to quit and open NVim again. Open Avante. Okay, I got my fingers crossed. One last time. 100th time is a charm. Hey, OpenAI, Codestral. Yes, this is our model. So it's taking longer, which is actually a good sign. The question is about comparing TypeScript to JavaScript, not about modifying the provided code snippet. Therefore, no changes are necessary or beneficial in this context. I like your style. Okay, so let's find some code. All right, let's open up our Avante.lua, and then we can ask, Are there any issues with this NeoVim config that would prevent me from accessing local AI via LLM Studio? All right, so it's able to use our window context that we have open to answer questions. And I'm actually really curious how that comes across on the LLM Studio side. Okay, so it doesn't look like it's giving us a lot of information on the logs except for the requests were being made. So we can't see how it's uploading the file precisely. But overall, super cool that we can generate these responses using our local running LLM Studio. Okay, so that's just a quick look at why LLM Studio is one of my favorite products right now. I have really been enjoying learning in very small, controlled ways a little bit more about AI, different AI models, and kind of like how we will continue to be interfacing with them in our tools, like our text editors and such. Obviously, I do wish it were a little bit faster in cases like the coding example. It's really funny that when the M1 silicon hardware came out, none of us really knew how to stress test these things except for like exporting videos or, you know, streaming, like multi-output streaming. And now it's wild that with AI we can stress them without even asking for too much. I think probably one of my next adventures is actually setting up a dedicated box or a rig to make these types of requests on my local network. That'd be super fun. And I have a Mac that might be perfect for it. Or maybe it's time for a 4090, who knows? Anyway, that's it. Thanks so much for hanging out. I hope that you found this helpful and that if you were interested in using LLM Studio for any of these use cases, that now you know a little bit more about it. And thank you for giving me an opportunity to actually dive into getting NeoVim connected. I'm super excited about it. Okay, that's it. You're awesome. Get out of here. Build your own on-prem AI stuff with LLM Studio. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.